Hi everyone, it's Ken LaRue once again from the Shotgun Team, and here's our tip for the day in our 30 tips in 30 days. This tip is focused on what's called task templates, and this is a very powerful feature that allows you to assign and create tasks associated with different shots, but it's the way you use these task templates that allows you to automate the process. So I'm going to jump to my project called New Project, and right now we have no shots. This is a brand new. There's no tasks. There's no assets or anything that's been created yet. Typical workflow would be I go back to my shots page. I create a new shot. I'll enter in a code for the shot. And I'll choose create. Now you'll notice that these tasks, the default tasks of layout, animation, effects, lights, and comp are not available to me here. That's because I've not assigned any. So if I go to the shots page, I can then come in and start to add different tasks to this. So I can say create a new task. I want this one to be layout. I could assign it to person, put start dates, put other information, but we'll just leave this like that. So now layout's been added. I want to add another task. So I add another task. This one's going to be animation. So I go to my pipeline steps and so on, create task. So as you can see, this is a time-consuming process, especially when I'm going to be creating tons of different shots. That workflow will work, but there's a more efficient way of assigning these tasks to your shots, and that's called task templates. So let's go back to my shots here, and I'm going to just get rid of this. I'm going to send this to the trash, so I have no shots now. I'll come all the way over here by my user settings, click down on the little arrow, the little triangle. I'll come down, and I'll choose task templates. We go to the task templates page, and there are several default ones that you can use, and these are great if this fits what you need. But if you want to create a new task template, I can just click this button that reads plus task template. Dialog box opens. I'll name this shots_Ken's template. For entity type, we want to choose what is this task template going to be used for. It's going to be used with shots. I could add a description, but I'm not going to. I'm just going to choose create task template. You'll now see it's been added into my flow. But notice under the task column, it reads zero. I have no task associated with this yet. So I'll double click on it to enter its own individual page. Now I can create a new task. So I click the plus task button, or I could have clicked create new task. But up here where task name, I'll name this layout. And then I can go to pipeline step and say I want this to be a layout step, which makes sense. I could assign this to an artist. I want Daryl to be doing all of the layouts. I can choose a start date, a duration, and so on, but I'm not going to do that right now. Let's just create the task. Great. Now you can see we've got our layout task. The pipeline step is layout, and Daryl has been assigned to it. Let's create some more tasks. I'll name this task animation. We'll choose the pipeline step animation. I want the artist Gary to be working on these. Now, instead of me clicking create task and the dialog box closes and I gotta reopen it, I can hold option, shift, or alt shift on Windows, I'm on a Mac here, and click create task and reset form. So you'll see animation's been added and my form has been reset. Now I wanna create my effects task. So I'll name it properly effects, I'll choose effects. I want this assigned to the artist named Laura. She's going to be doing all the effects work for these shots. And again, option shift, create task, and reset form. Now, instead of you watching me do this for the next couple of minutes as I create more tasks, let's use some editing magic and do some fast forwarding. So now I've created 5 different tasks in this task template, and each one of those tasks has been associated with a pipeline step. I've already populated what artist will be working on each one of these tasks for each shot. I can even select all of them, right-click over them, and choose dependency, link selected, because I know each one of these tasks is going to be dependent by the completion of the task prior to it. I could come in, change the status of each one of them. I could set the start date, the end date. And I'm not positive about these, but I do know that the layout is going to take 5 days. So I'm going to enter 5 days. I do know the animation is going to take 6 days. The effects, we're going to give it 5 days. The lighting, we're going to give it 3 days. And the comp, we're going to give it 5 days. So all of this data, all this information about the task are saved in the task template named Shots Ken's Template. All right, let's go back to the shots page now. I'm going to choose create new shot once again. So I'll give it a shot code, such as 2001. Now looking down below, you'll see the task template field. It's empty right now. If I click on it, I'm going to get all of the task templates that are available to me, including the one I just created named shots underscore Ken's template. I choose that. Now I want to create multiple shots here, so I'm going to use the hotkey option of holding the option key on Mac or Alt on Windows and Linux. So now I can create the shot, plus I can keep my form populated. So I click that button, you'll see the shot is created, and I have the ability to come in here now and enter shot underscore 2202, hold the option key, click create shots, keep form, come in here, enter 3, option key, click. We'll just create one more. I'll enter 4 for the end of this shot code, and then we click create shot. Now, if I go to look at the list view, you'll see there's all my shots with the shot code I just created, but notice that each one of them has the default task assigned to them because I use that task template. Now, if I go to the task page, you're going to see that each one of the shots is listed to me. It's got all the tasks, the pipeline step, the artist that's working on them, plus the duration. So now if I come in here and I say the start date for this layout is going to be tomorrow, all the other start and due dates are populated based on the duration. And you can see inside my Gantt chart, there is a link for the dependencies for the shot. Now I want to start entering the start date for the next shot, shot underscore 2202. So for the start date, I want this artist to start working on the layout the day after they complete the layout from the previous shot. So that would be this date. And again, Shotgun's going to automatically populate everything for me inside the Gantt and also these dates. So let's do this again. I'm going to come back over to this shot and I'm going to come down and tell it to start on this date. Populates it, and then I can come back down to the final one here and enter that. So now looking at the task page and looking at the Gantt chart, you can see that I have populated each one of the shots with the different tasks, the pipeline step associated with those tasks, the artist associated, the duration, the start, and the end date of 4 different shots very quickly because I used a task template. So that's our tip for today in our 30 tips in 30 days.